In 1904, the Rover Company produced its first cars. They were greeted with enthusiasm. A journalist wrote of a sweetly running car free from harassing peculiarities. The Rover had 8 horsepower, 1 cylinder. And 2 years later, Thomas Jefferson drove one of these remarkable vehicles from Coventry to Constantinople, over roads scarcely worthy of the name, through country that few modern drivers would care to risk. Up to now, the Rover Company had not played a great part in motor racing. But in 1907, a car was entered for the Isle of Man Tourist Trophy. Despite torrential rain, the sturdy Rover forged ahead and won the event. The 1909 Rover showed improvements on earlier models and did much to establish the company's reputation for solid engineering. Between 1910 and 1920, despite the restrictions on motoring imposed by the First World War, the Rover Company had some notable successes in hill climbs and reliability trials. It was in this period that the sea-roving Viking mascot was adopted to symbolize the name Rover. In the 1930s, life suddenly began to be very real, very earnest, and very competitive. The rapidly diminishing number of manufacturing firms in this country vied with each other in cutting prices. The nation's leaders called for economy. The Rover Company took a bold step. Considering that high quality was the soundest economy, it withdrew from the cutthroat race and decided to concentrate on a car designed and built to the most exacting standards. In the 9 years that followed, competition eliminated all but a small number of motor manufacturers. The Rover policy was justified. The Rover Company's Coventry works, marked as a top priority on the Luftwaffe's operational maps, were not spared. Only one thing was not destroyed in that night of baptism by fire, the will to win. The Rover Company made a fighting comeback. In a shadow factory at Solihull and elsewhere, it started making Meteor engines for the Cromwell tank. The jet aircraft engine was to provide another outlet for the company's engineering skill and experience. Converting a brilliant dream into a piece of practical engineering called for new materials, new methods, new techniques. A few years after the war, the Rover Company produced the Land Rover, most versatile wheeled vehicle ever made. This complete departure from routine car manufacture surprised the world. This car, and one of its replicas, went through many months of testing at the Motor Industry Research Association's test track, and the car that can stand up to thousands of miles of this and the other tests carried out by Rovers is fit for anything. If it is not shaken to breaking point on the pavé, fast periods on the switchback pumps may still find a weakness. And the gradients of 1 in 4 and 1 in 3 are as steep as anything encountered on the roads of the world. Solihull again, this time to the Rover factory itself, honored by a visit from the Duke of Edinburgh. The program is arranged to enable the Duke to see as much as possible during his 5-hour visit. And that program is flexible, for the Duke has a way of departing from timetables when a particular item captures his interest. That's the hallmark of a real enthusiast, and the Rover Company appreciate enthusiasts. After all, they're enthusiasts themselves.